Get your SISM training from Thor Peterson.
In this lecture, we're going to talk about data classification. And if you remember back when we talked about a certain system could have a certain protection profile, that would be based on the classification of the data on that system. I would know these and know the keywords for all of them, because this is somewhere where just knowing those keywords can maybe get you a point or two more on the exam. You need to read the question and figure out what exactly are they asking, not what do you want to answer. This could be a couple of sentences, we're doing this, we have this data, and then somewhere in there, there's a keyword that says grave or serious. Then from that keyword, you know that this is top secret or secret. And you can see the logical flow here, most secret to least secret, from top to the bottom. So top secret, exceptionally grave damage to national security. That's weapon blueprints, at least new ones, war plans, espionage data. On the private sector side of things, confidential is also exceptionally grave damage. And that can be anything that we have that is proprietary. That can be our trade secrets, the secret sauce that we use, our source code, or anything really that gives us a competitive advantage, where if we lost that, it would have serious impacts on our business. For secret, it is either serious damage or critical damage. That can be troop plans, deployment plans, and anything else that is not included in top secret, but is still very critical. In the private sector, that could be PHI, PII, our financial data, employee data, our payroll. Losing it is not going to cripple us as a business, but it can have serious, both financial and reputation ramifications. Confidential can cause damage to national security, and that could be intelligence reports, battle reports, or mobilization plans. On the private sector, that would be sensitive. Again, it can cause damage to us. And this would be things like our networking diagrams, our IP assignments, and any software or system-specific data that if someone else has, can potentially cause us damage. I mean, this is where most attacks start. They try to map our network, they try to find the IP addresses, they try to find specific information about our systems or our software. When they have that, well, then they start looking for the things that they're actually after. And then finally, we have unclassified or public. Unclassified does not mean it is publicly available. In many cases, you would need to request access to those and be granted it. And the military technically has one more. It is not a classification, but still something they use. Sensitive, but unclassified. And that is somewhat like the private classification in the private sector, PII, PHI, payroll, employee data. It's not classified, but it is sensitive information we do not want leaked. And when we talk about clearance and classification, it is way, way more granular than just top secret or secret. An individual might have top secret nuclear submarine. And then on top of that, they would also need a good reason to request access to that data. Remember, military is mandatory access control. The data have labels assigned to them. The data are objects. Remember, objects are manipulated by subjects. And then the subjects have clearance assigned to them, which is based on their current and future trustworthiness. And the higher clearance you have, the more in-depth the background checks should be, but that doesn't always mean they are. In the military, yes, they are always in-depth. In the private sector, well, that kind of depends. The keywords here really are objects have labels, subjects have clearance, and it is based on the current and future trustworthiness. I wanted to finish out this lecture by looking at formal access approval, need to know, and least privilege. Formal access approval is where you have that top secret nuclear submarine clearance, but you still need to be granted access to the data. Here, the data owner approves your access, and then as the subject, you have to understand all the requirements for accessing the data and the liability that is involved if the data in your possession is lost, destroyed, or compromised. See this as discretionary access control inside of mandatory access control. Need to know is where you have access to way more than you need to do your day-to-day job. But you are allowed to access the data if you have a need to know it. If you access it and you do not have a need to know, well, then there will be consequences. We give our doctors and nurses access to all patient records, but they have to be treating that patient to be allowed to access it. They can, of course, access it without having a need to know, but then, after the fact, there will be consequences. Need to know is mostly used with role-based access control, and this is what most of the private sector uses. Least privilege is mandatory access control, and that is what most armed forces use. We give people access to exactly what they need to do, their day-to-day job, but nothing more. If something happens or they need more access, well, then we grant it on a case-by-case basis. And I know there are places in the armed forces where they also use role-based access control, but it is still a substructure below mandatory access control. It doesn't make a lot of sense to have to grant access to a network admin every time he or she needs to work on a new system. And with that, we are done with this lecture. I will see you in the next one. If you liked the video, please leave a thumbs up and remember to subscribe to the channel. To get my courses and the free study materials, click on Learn More. Thank you, and I will see you in the next video.